Pope Francis knocks down expectations for next month's Vatican Summit on Clergy Sex Abuse.
Una aspettativa gonfiata.
Aboard the papal plane returning from World Youth Day in Panama, the Holy Father said expectations are inflated. Last year, Pope Francis summoned all presidents of bishops' conferences from around the world to address the abuse crisis. Alan Holdren is the EWTN Rome Bureau Chief. Alan, in the U.S., all eyes are on this abuse summit. Why is the Pope trying to dampen expectations?
Well, I think he's seen, Lauren, that the expectations that have been built up are way too big for these 3 days, basically, of meetings that they have, followed by a fourth day with a mass. He said today that he wants to deflate those expectations to something concrete, that the bishops take care of victims, that they know the procedures, and that they take them home and they know how to investigate cases or potential cases. I think that's realistic, Lauren.
Pope Francis also spoke about another hot-button issue, priestly celibacy.
Yeah, he said he's not going to give any sort of a go-ahead to lift the requirement for celibacy in the Catholic Church, in the Roman Catholic Church. He said that in other rites there are married clergy. He said that in the Roman Catholic Church he would be willing to evaluate, consider the possibility of ordaining older married men that live in remote, far-flung parts of the world so that they would be able to give the sacraments to the Catholics in their areas. He said that for him, the celibacy in the Catholic Church is a gift, and that he would not put himself between God and that gift.
You know, one of the things that really interested me about his trip is when he was in Panama, this crisis in nearby Venezuela was just exploding, and the bishops in that country have expressed support for a very peaceful resolution. But the Pope's position, I'm sure, is peaceful. What else did he say?
Yeah, he said after Mass on Sunday, yesterday, with more than 600,000 people there present, he said that he supports a just and peaceful solution. There in Venezuela, he's very well informed on what's going on, and he knows that anything he says could be taken by one or the other side and used against the other side. He mentioned that in the press conference today. He said he supports a common agreement, and he said, I know that I can get me in trouble as well. I'm not supposed to say anything that could be construed as one side or the other. He said that he supports the people of Venezuela, and he's absolutely terrified that it could come to a bloodbath. He said that violence is not the solution.
I have thought about that every time I see all of that footage. What would happen if one side just got really hot? Alan, Pope Francis celebrated the closing mass, and as you said, it was about 600,000 people. I was talking to my daughter about that today, and I was like, that's almost the size of the city of Washington, D.C. Yet the Holy Father was asked why young people are turning away from the church. What did he say?
He said that some of it is due to personal reasons. Most of it, he said, is general reasons. He spoke specifically about the Christian witness of church leaders. He said priests, bishops, even the Pope himself have to show their witness. They can't be businessmen. They can't just have an organization and a pastoral plan and just rely on that. They have to be in amongst the people. And he said that applies to all of them down to the last one.
Alan Holdren, EWTN Rome Bureau Chief. Thank you, Alan, for joining us.
Thank you, Lauren.